Hey everybody, welcome back to Leosophy. This is the second in the marketing series, and it's really more just about social media marketing specifically. And the reason why I think that's so important is, one, it's basically free. In fact, in most cases, it is free. And it's also really easy to do, because at this point, I mean, if you're listening to this video, you should have some understanding of social media. You almost certainly have at least one social media account. So you kind of know just intuitively how to be a customer, user, whatever the word you'd prefer to use on social media. In other words, you're familiar with being an individual and not a business, not a service, not a podcast or a platform or anything that would want to market itself under normal circumstances, influencer even. So you understand at least the fundamentals though. And that's one of the reasons why it's such a good aspect to start with when talking about marketing, because it's also one of the ones I see people mess up the most on. And that includes like big businesses, but influencers or would-be influencers would be more accurate, because it's kind of pivotal understanding that to actually being successful in podcasters, small businesses, solopreneurs, coaches. I mean, so many people get this wrong on social media. And what amazes me about it is that they understand intuitively that it's wrong when they're on there as an individual, but when they're on there for themselves, they miss it. And I guess it's because they're close to it. And so this is the like rule number one of social media. It's not a calendar, and it's not like just a little reminder tool. Like, think about your favorite people that you follow on social media. How often do they have posts? It's like new episode drop, and then that's it. Or check out my live show here, and that's it. Almost none of them, if any of them, do that, because one, it doesn't bring any value. You don't go on there to get reminders from people. And yet I see a lot of people do that. You know, our new burger's on sale, 20% off. Use promo code burger. That's not what most people want. Most people want to follow something because it's entertaining. It has a separate form of value. So number one, if you want to promote anything on social media, what I recommend doing, step one, make an account for your business or whatever entity you're trying to promote. And step two, don't promote it. Yeah, just go on there and find people who are similar, other burger chains, other life coaches, other consultants, other podcasters, other people who install windshields on cars. Find people like that, and things that are secondary to that, like in the last analogy of, you know, automotive entities, car collectors even. Put that as an interest, for example. And then just like and comment and be friendly like you would if you were an individual. That's step one, or step two, really, because we're a little further down the road now. But that's a big one, is just liking and commenting with no ulterior motive at all. This is one of the reasons why a lot of people hire interns to do this crap, because they're literally paying these Zoomers to just basically use Twitter and or whatever, and not in a way that would reflect bad on the company, but still more like an individual. Wendy's is famous for this. You know, I mean, you picture it, the little fun things that Wendy's post. You picture it being Wendy and not some neckbeard. And you know that's the deal. It's some flipping neckbeard who's pretty clever, you know, not keen on stand-up necessarily, but very witty, at least in writing. And they make fun posts, and people follow Wendy's because of the fun posts, not because Wendy's is constantly posting, we have burgers, we have a sale, we have a new menu item. That's annoying. Nobody wants that. People don't want to be just nudged, hey, this exists. That's not what marketing's about. Marketing's about persuasion. It's not about just letting people know that something exists. I mean, you could do that. In fact, that's the earliest form of marketing, but it's not sustainable when you're competing with a zillion other people for folks' attention. And that's not why they're on social media. So that's one. And then the other recommendation I have, in addition to just posting and liking and sharing and commenting in a very non-combative way with your competitors, they're not really. That's another cardinal rule of social media is don't treat people like they're your competitors. And then the other thing is when you do post about things in direct reference to your business, do it from a more emotional angle. You know, if you just partnered up with somebody new, present that more as an individual, feeling so grateful to have met the great folks at X and looking forward to a future relationship with them. Not, we partnered with, you know, this marshmallow company, so now we have marshmallows in our cereal. Like, it's more about you as an individual and how it makes you feel. Those kinds of things resonate with people. Perfect example of that would be, I really like Ricky Berwick on every platform, frankly, but whenever he posts things, not his vids, it's not links to his vids. It's literally just like fun things that have nothing to do with that. And it makes you interested. So that's the number one way to do social media marketing is you don't really do marketing in and of itself. You use it more like an individual without the ulterior motive. You just traffic in circles that are more in line with your business and less in line with what your other interests might be. That's really it. That, and, you know, be careful about what you say. You know, if you're selling, I don't know, sandwiches, you got a little deli or something, maybe don't get super political, you know, things like that. It sounds really obvious, but people do. They mess that up. That was that spice company. Remember that? They were like, we don't want no publicans buying our spices. And they just like went under because nobody wanted to buy their spices. So yeah, that's really it in a nutshell. Social media marketing, very different from all the other ones for that reason. It's very easy if you approach it more like a person and not a business. That's all I got for that one. Like, share, subscribe. Keep asking questions. Bye.